Pet owners know pets are the best. What things do you unfortunately know from experience? Being lonely can make you think and act in ways that will only perpetuate the problem, if not make it worse. How do you solve that? Short answer, be friendly and open. Don't expect people to approach you, but don't come on strong. Or expect relationships to build and solidify quickly. Let people get to know you in their own time. You can work your ass off, stay late, work after hours, and devote your time and energy to a career and end up getting laid off when business is in trouble. I had glowing reviews. I was well liked. Up for a promotion. The business and the numbers don't care. This is what I was going to say. Always put yourself first at work, over your employer. They will. Who do you work for? My family. Money doesn't mix with friends or family. Never give someone money that you aren't willing to burn. It can mix, but don't make it a loan. Make it a gift. If the other person demurs at the idea of a gift rather than a loan, say, "I know you would do the same thing for me." That's the correct answer. Friends who owe you money will generally stop being friends. Not because they are bad people or anything. It's just the sad reality that if they are in a position that they need to borrow from friends, they are unlikely to be in a position to repay their friends. If you ask for the money back, it'll create stress and they will end up trying to avoid you. And even if you never ask for it, they may feel guilty about owing you and will avoid you. Loans between friends and family suck. Either give it as a gift or not at all. Just because someone hasn't broken up with you or clings to the relationship doesn't mean they really want to be with you. Sometimes you have to break your own heart to get out of an unpleasant situation. I feel like some people can want to not hurt your feelings, but by doing so they just make it worse because they can't be honest and say they aren't happy. Not everyone has family or even parents who love them. People always assume everyone does this. And no person ever needs to forgive the shit their parents did or lack doing simply because they are your parents. The term fireproof is always relative. Nothing tragic or anything. Let's just say, if you're getting into metalwork, don't cheap out on your PPE. Don't ignore slash excuse red flags. Yup, don't make excuses for someone else or forgive them repeatedly. People are perfectly aware of what they are doing. And by forgiving them, you let them take advantage of you. Always keep your mouth closed when cleaning the toilet with a toilet brush. I do this all the time because I'm just scared. Never experienced it, just dark foreseeing. Wear a mask. Closing your mouth won't stop toilet juice from splashing on your lips. It's not what you know, it's who you know, is not just a trite saying. Very much this. If you have no solid connections, you're not necessarily totally screwed, but at a severe disadvantage. I gave an older lady a job when I was hiring manager for a big project. When we got laid off, we both found other gigs. Over a year later, laid off again. Guess who got me another job? Don't burn bridges and help folks when you can. That shit comes around both ways. That some people are just going to be a-holes no matter what. Thinking back, sometimes those people are me. You can do everything right and still not make some people happy, only almost happy. It's designed like a dangling carrot just outside of your reach. With just one more push, you may be able to grasp it, but you won't because it's impossible. If you stop trying to grab the carrot, you will upset them. That's a price worth paying. You are not responsible for someone else's happiness. You are not responsible for someone else's emotions or what they decide they think about you. Sounds like you are trying to be a good person in the world. We need more people like that. I hope you have found your happiness. You're the only person you can try to make happy. If they can't decide if they want to date you or someone else, take yourself out of the equation. Don't make someone a priority if you're only an option. Joke's on you, me. I'm always out of the equation. That even the worst food does not taste like shit. Who did this to you? Unfortunately, I know this too. I grew up on a farm. There are a lot of instances one can find out what shit tastes like in that context, and because it's the internet, I need to note that all of those instances are purely by accident in my experience. I don't judge what someone else wants to eat, but in my life, this has not been intentional. LMAO. Never co-sign for a friend. Never co-sign for anyone. I've co-signed for two things in my life, one for a friend, and one for my dad. I had to pay for both in the end. 15-year-old, you may be able to do a cartwheel. 35-year-old, you probably can't. Source: lying on the ground holding my knee and trying not to swear, while the 3-year-old cousin I was trying to entertain laughs his head off and repeatedly asks me to do it again. Stress impacts not only your mental health, but your physical health too. Every time finals week rolls around, the acne flares up, back pain gets bad, and my bowels go crazy. You do not decide if you pet the goat decides if you pet the goat. Never make someone your everything, because when they leave, you'll have nothing. It's illegal to ship food from Australia to South Korea. Thankfully, the post office worker made sure to check what I was shipping, or I could have ended up in serious trouble. What? That is so odd. I guess it's a way to try to keep out non-native species and diseases? Yeah, found out from a podcast that New Zealand is the same way. When you get hungry, sometimes you're not actually hungry. Now this one is pretty interesting. So apparently our brains don't know the difference between thirst and hunger, so many of the times you get thirsty your brain will send signs of hunger when you actually just need some water. It's worse than that. Sometimes you're not hungry, you're just bored. War is not noble or glorious. It's ducking brutal and awful. Even though we don't swing swords and axes anymore, it's still an awful lot of hard work. But yeah, I guess killing people is hard work. I can picture in my mind a world without war, a world without hate, and I can picture us attacking that world because they'd never expect it. Jack Handy. It doesn't matter how much you give to a narcissist, they'll always expect more. But take it all away, and all hell breaks loose. Never assume you have a lot of time. Thanks for reminding me to do my assignment. I'm not as smart as I thought I was as a teenager. The older I get, the smarter I used to be. The older I get, the more I realize I'm a lot effing smarter than I thought, and I'm disappointed I didn't realize it earlier. Never combine bleach and ammonia. Sure, everyone knows that. But as a kid, I just made a mental note to not combine flasks labeled bleach and ammonia when hanging out in a lab. Skip to young adult years, I'm working in a vet clinic, and what do I spray into a litter box with Tomcat piss in it? Well, it was extra stinky, so I skipped the chlorohex and went for the bleach spray, of course. I was also in a tiny little room with a tub but no ventilation. It was like breathing in gas that ignited in my throat. Lesson learned. I believe the combo creates chlorine gas, which is pretty damn dangerous. This is a common misconception. It's not chlorine gas, it's trichloramine. Smells similar, but it's not as toxic as actual chlorine gas. That said, I wouldn't want to inhale either of them. Other fun fact, when measuring ammonia, many techniques use something called the Berthelot reaction. It specifically requires adding chlorine to ammonia. Never assume you have a lot of time. CPR has an abysmally low success rate. Can we just put out there that a low success rate is infinitely more successful than not attempting CPR? Don't not do it, because it probably won't work. And even if it's bad CPR, it's better than no CPR. Also, on this topic, before you start, ensure that someone has called an ambulance. If you're on your own, this means call before you start, cause there isn't any stopping once you begin, unless you're physically exhausted. Some good tips: make sure help is coming first. It's tough and exhausting work, so if there is more than one of you, take it in turns every couple of minutes to do chest compressions. You have to compress quite hard and deep to be effective. Move the person off any bed or couch or cushion thing onto a floor, otherwise it won't be effective. If you have to drag the person in a way that's not that great to get them on the floor, that's okay. Any bruises and cuts will heal if they survive, although do try and protect the head and neck if possible. Being stabbed in the back hurts, especially when you have no idea it's coming. Literally or figuratively. If it was literal, it'd hurt less. Tensing up is bad. Sometimes your poop conspires with your fart to come out at the same ducking time. This can also happen during strong orgasms, so buyer beware. I know my wife loves me. I knew it before it happened, but now I really know it. Welp, I have a new fear. Holding on to anger only poisons you. When you're hurt and backed into a corner, suddenly everyone becomes an enemy. Anger and depression go hand in hand. Having a kid with special needs requires a very patient and prepared parent. My brother has special needs, and my parents have been worn down because of it. They are both borderline alcoholics partly due to the stress involved of it, and many arguments are created because of parenting disagreements. Basically, it can really complicate family dynamics. I tend to keep to myself to avoid the arguing and constant conflict. Note, I love my brother and I'm not trying to sound insensitive here. Just trying to shed some light on a perspective not touched on often.